In this video, we'll get started with the RFIC power cell array. Our goal is to utilize repetition of elements in our design methodology. We'll telescope from the smallest element, a transistor, all the way up to the final cell. Before we can get started, we need to set up the layout command line. The command line can give us better control over our layout. On your main window, go to Tools, App Manager. Enable the Layout Command Line Editor. After you close out of the dialog, you will need to reboot ADS to make sure that the command line is enabled. We also need to verify a few settings in Layout View. Go to Tools, Set Connectivity Options, and select What You See Is What You Get Connectivity Mode. Under Options Preferences, in the Entry Edit tab, make sure you've unchecked Shove Connected Shapes and Move Handles Enabled, and selected Disable Drag and Move. Under the Grid Snap tab, make sure you've unchecked Pin Snap. We are now ready to get started. Here is a schematic of the transistor. The transistor itself is part of the PDK that I'm using. Let's work on the layout for this transistor. Go to Window, Layout. ADS keeps track of the differences between the layout view and the schematic view. Press Update on the differences from schematic pane, then place the transistor on the origin. Although this device works as is, we need to make a few changes for logistical and thermal reasons. The emitter needs to be extended through the bottom of the IC, and the collectors need vias to reach the top of the IC. We'll change to the Palette tab and add vias on the collectors. For accurate placement, I have actually temporarily disabled snap so I can get the vias right on the edge of the metal layer. We're now going to extend the emitter. Before we can work with the individual shapes of the device, we need to flatten it. Select the device, go to Edit, Component, Flatten, and select the Flatten All Levels option. Let's toggle the visibility of our layers so we can see what we're working with a little more clearly. Currently, the emitter is on the metal one layer. Toggle off all other layers, then turn on the visibility only for metal one. Then, extend the emitter to the edge of the original emitter, and delete the old emitter. We now have to verify that this design follows our design rules. Press D to run the DRC. I'll select one of the design rule definitions provided by the PDK. As you can see, there are no design rule issues. Now that we know that there's nothing wrong with the physical layout of our design, we make sure that the schematic and layout are synced. Press L to run LVS. Since we've converted our device to shapes, we can't run a one-to-one comparison of the layout and the schematic. Under Options, check Device Recognition with Physical Nets. Note that there are no issues detected with LVS. The only warning that comes up is that we have not used all the pins from the schematic. This is fine, as the device will be used later as part of a larger device, and we do not need to worry about pin connections for simulation. To use this device in larger schematics, go to Window, Symbol. In the Generator dialog, select the Copy Modify tab, Devices BJT, then BJT NPN. We've now generated a symbol for use in future schematics. This concludes the first part of the RFIC power cell design. Thank you for watching this Keysight eSoft EDA tutorial. You can find a link to a free trial of ADS in the video description below.